Hey guys, today I am going to discuss you about an application of operon theory. So first of all, we have to know what is operon. A operon is gene action, how a gene acts or reacts. 50% work of central dogma is done by a operon. Now the question is, what happens when an E. coli cell is placed into a glucose medium from a lactose medium? It is easy to answer that the operon of that cell is repressed to work. Now the question is, why it is repressed to work? If you see the operon theory, you can see a DNA templates or a operon templates has some special area where some special genes are situated. These genes are arranged from 5 prime to 3 prime like this manner: regulator, promoter, operator and structural genes. These structural genes are Z, Y and A. Now from a DNA strand, an mRNA strand is produced. This mRNA produces some repressor proteins and some other proteins. These repressor proteins blocks the operator gene of operon and mRNA synthesis is stopped. In lactose medium, this repressor protein is repressed by the lactose of the lactose medium. The lactose joins to the allosteric site of the repressor protein and changes its shape and makes a lactose repressor protein complex. So, the polycystronic mRNA chain is continuously produced. This mRNA produces some proteins in the form of enzyme. These enzymes are beta-galactosidase, lac-permiase, trans-acitylase. But when the E. coli cell is placed into the glucose medium, due to lack of lactose, the repressor protein represses the operon to work. Now, how the operon is repressed? Interestingly, in glucose medium, beta-galactosidase acts on lactose repressor protein complex and breaks down the lactose into glucose and galactose. Finally, the repressor protein is free from the repressor protein complex and it represses the operon to work. So this is all about an application of operon theory. Next time, I will be back with some more useful topics of biology.